In 2019, Google made quantum computing history. Our quantum computer completed a benchmark computation in 200 seconds that would have taken the world's fastest supercomputer at the time 10,000 years. In 2024, Google reran the experiment on our latest chip, Willow, and saw a significant leap forward. We got Hartmut, Neven, and Sergio Boixo together with theoretical physicist John Preskill to talk about what this means.
Since we introduced the benchmark in 2019, we keep running it every year, and the times it would take for a classical supercomputer to emulate or to simulate the latest benchmarks that we can run on our quantum processors has grown tremendously.
It grew from 10,000 years in 2019 to 10 to the power of 25 years, or in words, 10 septillion years on the Willow chip. This illustrates the double exponential growth in compute power.
There's an interesting aspect to the superiority of the quantum computer. The Google hardware has improved a lot in recent years, as we've been hearing, but it still makes lots of mistakes. So they have to run it many times in order to extract a usable signal that can be compared with that classical simulation. They, in fact, run it millions of times, but they can do that in just a few minutes, which is still a very short time compared to the resources you would need to do the same simulation on a classical machine.
John popularized it with the name quantum supremacy at the time. At Google, we tend to call it a billion classical computation, but it's all just the same idea. It's trying to make true experimentally for the first time the promise of quantum computers. So here at Google, we use this benchmark, random circuit sampling, to compare our latest experimental quantum processors with the best classical algorithms running on the best supercomputers that we have available.
We should emphasize that random circuit sampling is not useful for an application. It's just the entry point. If you can't win on random circuit sampling, you can't win on any other algorithm either. The next challenge will be to train this enormous compute power towards tasks that people on Main Street would care for.
And by the way, even if the people on Main Street don't care, it could still be very interesting. I think the quantum hardware has reached a stage now where it can advance science. We can study very complex quantum systems in a regime that we've never had access to before. And for me as a physicist, that's quite exciting. And with the hardware that people are developing now, which is continuing to improve, we can look for new types of matter that have never existed before and study their properties. That's already a big deal.
Two things happened since 2019. First, the classical algorithms improved, you know, with a lot of work from an extended community of computer scientists. They have improved by around a factor of a billion, so a huge factor that is actually quite surprising. But our quantum processors and actually experimental processors from other groups as well have improved even faster.
Part of what's significant compared to, say, 5 years ago, is now we have systems that have more qubits and higher quality qubits, so we can do computations that we couldn't do 5 years ago.
There is this idea that the computational cost increases exponentially with the number of qubits, or more precisely with what we call the volume. But it turns out that the volume is also increasing exponentially, because the error rates are decreasing with time. So there is a double exponential increase of the computational cost with time, and that's what we call Neven's law.
And by the way, that's really fast.
That's really
fast. Double exponential.
The very next thing we want to do is we want to demonstrate that we can really improve error correction. In the experimental quantum processors that we have today, there is always this competition between errors or noise in the system and quantumness or computational power.
It's really a three-way race. There's the quantum computer, there's the classical computer,
and
there's the noise. And if you guys are going to win, you have to fight off both the noise and the classical machine.
After the 2019 result, we published a roadmap how to get to what we think will be a quantum computer that can confidently deliver commercial value. And we packed it to be a computer with 1,000 well-protected logical qubits, which probably means about 1,000,000 physical qubits. And we published a roadmap how to get there. It has 6 milestones, and we are now approaching the 3rd milestone. So we are about halfway through our roadmap. And we are not much delayed relative to what we say the timeline would be. So I've said this before, my subtitle here is Chief Optimist, but I think just tracking our progress date is that we should see early commercial applications. So I would think it's more half a decade or a few years rather than multiple decades.
One must be optimistic. That's how great things happen. And this guy is very good at it.